Hi, and welcome to the Virtual Boat Show. I'm Eric Dallin with the A Marine Group, and today we're with Eric Kunz, who's with Furuno, and we're going to talk about the TZtouch3 from Furuno, all-glass display. I'm excited to see some of the features. Eric, welcome to the show.
Hey, thank you, Eric. How you doing?
I'm doing well, man. Socially isolating, but what do we say? Nautically connected, right?
Yeah, me too. I'm a little more shaggy. I've been living a little like a caveman, but I'm here, and I'm ready, really happy to talk about the TZtouch3 product line.
That's awesome. I see. So we're zooming out a little bit, looking at your desk. So you got a lot of gear and equipment.
Tell us
what you got going on.
The great thing about Furuno this year is that we're not just introducing a brand new TZtouch3 product line with three different MFDs, a 12-inch, a 16-inch, and a 19-inch, which are kind of a pretty tremendous improvement over our TZtouch2 product line as far as MFDs go. But we also have brand new heading sensors. This, what I'm holding right here, is an SCX-20 and then the SCX-21, which are basically satellite compasses that are revolutionary in design, in that each one has four GPS antennas, and they're a lot more flexible on where you can mount them on a boat. Just for your customers to know, GPS heading sensors have been around for a long time, but the nice thing about these new compasses is that they have more than two antennas, which is unlike any other product on the market. And the bane of these products in the past has been that you had to really give them a lot of the sky for them to work properly. But now with these new designs, we have four antennas, can calculate the heading from a lot of different angles. So local obstructions on the boat are not such a big problem. Also, in addition to that, we say this year we're going on a power trip with Furuno because we have two brand new radar sensors, the DRS-12 ANXT and the DRS-25 ANXT, which are 100 watt and 200 watt output power radar sensors, which are the highest in the market in the recreational, even light commercial world. So these are really exciting products for us. In addition to the TZtouch3 MFDs, we have built-in, within the TZtouch3 MFD, there's also a built-in dual-channel chirp sounder or chirp fish finder. And that's revolutionary for us, too. We've never put so much power with chirp technology inside our MFDs before. So these are just TZtouch3 features, and I'm really happy to be here to talk to you about them.
Yeah, so we're running. I put up on the screen while you were talking. I started just a little bit early, but I wanted to show. So this is a video, kind of the features and benefits video from your website that's running in the background, and okay. It highlights some of those features you talked about. I like this idea that you've got this. A lot of these features and functionalities that used to be across a lot of different pieces of equipment, really being housed in that central display. Give me some rundowns on what we can expect to see that makes this an upgrade from the Touch 2.
Well, the great thing about it is we've increased the power dramatically. These new machines have quad-core processors, so they're a lot more powerful in terms of memory, and we've added more memory and capabilities and functionalities. We have some new NavNet command center features that incorporate other systems on the boat that you can bring in to control virtually your whole boat from within the TZtouch3 user interface. And that's a nice thing about these new MFDs. They're so powerful that they're kind of creating an ecosystem to control basically the entire vessel from within the MFDs. And for redundancy, you just add another MFD into the system. If you wanted to, say, have two MFDs, you have fully redundant system. You could be navigating on one MFD and changing light switches or changing pump controls or looking at your water maker status or just about anything else you can imagine, all the other navigation tasks, as well as simple electrical system information and engine data on the display. So these are kind of incorporating everything into a single system. You control it all from a single user interface. And that's one of the best things about TZtouch3 is the improved and the swipe gesture user interface, which I'll show you in a minute.
That's, you know what, the fishing footage that we've got on the screen now is killing me. So I understand since we're kind of isolated here and it's been a minute since I've gotten out of the water. Let's switch over. I understand you're going to show us a tutorial and some of the basic functionalities here on your desktop.
That's right. Let's jump into that. I'm going to stream the actual MFD right into your home. So anybody who's watching right now can actually check out exactly how the user interface works. I'll describe some of the touches that I'm doing, But this machine I'm looking at right now is a TZtouch3 12. It's a TZT12. And it's a 12-inch machine. It's actually got hybrid controls on it. And we know that for smaller boats, it's nice sometimes to be able to anchor your hand on the side of the display and control it with knobs and buttons. But the nice thing is you still have full control from the multi-touch screen as well. So there's gestures and all kinds of other things. And you can use either way to touch the screen as you like. On the larger machines, they are all glass, the 16 and the 19. But we do also offer hybrid controls for those as well that just plug in simply with a USB connection. So you can have the same functionality in all three machines with this new MFD line, but the touch control and the hybrid control is built into the 12-inch. So that's all. But let's look at how this actually works. You can see that when you start the machine, we have an introduction page. And if you're familiar with the machine and you don't need to know how it actually works, you can actually just go right in and say, let's navigate. But I'm going to actually run this little tutorial button. It says Start Tour. I'm going to touch that right now. And I'm going to go in for customers that aren't familiar with the TZtouch3 user interface or TZtouch2. It's very similar. TZtouch3 is more refined. But you can see that we're actually going to have a built-in tutorial that just is kind of a couple-minute refresher. That anytime you get on the boat, if you don't remember how to operate the machine or use the machine in certain ways, you can see some of the functionalities. A new event icon, range bars. We have a new root bar at the top. We've basically refined all the capabilities and functionalities of TZtouch 2 and pushed it into TZtouch 3. There's a slider bar for zooming. You can always center the vessel. You have no fear of swiping and going anywhere. You can always get back. And we have swipe out gestures. Also, you can see that there's a hand coming on the screen. You can pinch to zoom. So there's multi-touch control at any time you want. You also have, with this 12-inch, like I said, this knob that you can also control the unit. No problem. You can instantly pan the chart. Go wherever you want. Hit that center button to go right back automatically. Really simple. And you can actually go in and use the hybrid control in the same way for chart panning. There's some single-tap actions. It brings up a contextual menu where you can just quickly make a new point, make a route, edit the point, delete a point. There's really a lot of functions. You can see we're making a quick route. We come up with route pads. So when you get done with the route, you can, or during the editing process, you can easily adjust it. There's also a 3D button. One of the nice things about TZtouch 3 and the map media charts that we use is that not only do we put in all the NOAA raster and vector charts, but we also include the Navionics and CMAP charts, and you get that all on a single chip when you buy the machine. You can just unlock the charts that you don't need. So the entire continental U.S. and our commonwealths are free. All that data is free. All the NOAA charts are free. If you want to add charts from other parts of the world, that's where we have to pay money and we have to charge for it. But they're all in the machine, and you just have to unlock them, basically for this half of the planet.
That makes it easy.
Yeah, it does. It really makes it simple. You don't have to send out cards. And even if you do need new charts or want to update your charts, you can just update the actual chip itself rather than having to receive new chips anywhere in the world.
Mm-hmm. And this is consistent with a trend that just that ease of boat, just making boating easier, making it easier to navigate, making it easier to monitor, making it easier to see what's happening with your boat and around it.
Exactly. And that's what the nice thing about this edge swipe features that we're showing right now are. We have quick pages where it's like an old radio dial. If I press the button, it'll automatically save that quick page that I want to save as a favorite. So, and you can add more or change them on the fly. It's really pretty cool. Custom displays are also super easy. Touch the home button, go in and press, you know, quad screen with TZtouch 3 and have a chart, a radar, two different kinds of acoustic sensors, a DFF 3D multi-beam sonar, and the built-in chirp. 1 kilowatt fish finder. Really cool how you can set up all these different displays however you like them, or customize your data boxes. Really pretty simple. So this tutorial that we're watching is built in, and it's just a way to refamiliarize yourself with the system. If I want to bounce out I just touch the screen and says, do you want to stop? Okay, stop. And then we're just going to click let's navigate. And that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just going to go in and show you some of the same features we just looked at. For example, if I touch the home button, it'll bring up my customization page. Again, I press the plus key and I want to add a new screen. Here's a quad screen I'm going to build where I bring up, say, two different data boxes, my down sounder and my chart plotter, and click enter. And this is the basic system. When you start to get more information, you can see I'm going to swipe over here and look at my tank levels and my heading information. Or if I wanted to bring up, for example, different engine configurations that are already built in. If I have a triple engine boat, I can already have that page built in. Or if I have a twin engine boat, I can actually use that page and delete the other pages. So these are just pre-configured information to allow you to use the TZtouch3 system as a complete boat control product, including navigation.
I like the convenience that you guys have built in that allows you to switch functionality based on what you're doing without having to go back into the back end and change a lot of settings. So if I'm en route to the fishing grounds, for example, I can watch and set up the screen one way and then very quickly shift over to what I might want to see while I'm trolling.
That's right. Here's a great example with TZtouch3 of just how easy it is. One of the things that I've found, and I've been in situations with captains, is that when you get into tight quarters and you have a lot of AIS targets, for example, let me zoom out. You can see here, this is a demo mode, but you can see right in here in Seattle area, there's a lot of AIS targets in this harbor, in this marina. Now, with some of our competitors' products, you have to go into the menu. Like, look at all those. They're just so clustered. And this is what the screens look like. But if you want to clear that up, our competitors' products is like 5, 6, 7, 8 keystrokes to undo or to turn off the AIS targets. Watch with Furuno how easy it is with this TZtouch3 user interface. I'm going to swipe up from the bottom to turn on my layers menu and instantly click AIS targets off, touch the screen anywhere else, and boom, you see how easily that screen cleans up. Or if I wanted to go in, for example, and do side-by-side chart, and you can see here where I touch the screen, that's the active screen on the right. If I touch it, you'll see a gold barrier come around the left side. I just touch the left side. Maybe I want to turn the AIS targets off on the left screen, but keep them on the right screen. So you can see I can have these two different views, really, or even go into 3D on one screen, look far ahead, and still keep a 2D view on the other screen. Super simple. Touch that little 3D icon again to turn it off. These are just some of the things and some of the functions and features of the TZtouch3 user interface that make it so simple to use.
Yeah, that's got to resonate with the market. So what's the feedback been as you guys have rolled this out?
You know, we're getting a lot of great feedback. A lot of people are really interested in the product. And the nice thing about Furuno is that it's not just the MFDs. It's our amazing sensors, our award-winning sensors. Our radars are arguably the finest in the world, in the industry. We've been making these satellite compass products since the year 2000. It's proven technology. It's saved countless, you know, gallons of fuel by allowing, you know, low-cost satellite compass heading systems, where in the past these shipping companies used to have use gyro compasses, very expensive systems, or they couldn't afford that. They would use a magnetic compass, which would push the boat all over the ocean. You know, sometimes you know, magnetic interference can cause a magnetic compass to deviate by, you know, 3, 4, even 10 or 15 degrees, depending on what's going on. And these satellite compasses are always right on the money, and they'll save fuel and time, and they'll end up paying for themselves, which is the great thing about the product.
Yeah, many of hours of confusion have been created by somebody setting a phone or something down a little too close to that compass and getting that interference. So.
Exactly.
I don't speak from experience in that regard.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, Eric, that's great. Any other highlights you want to go over with us before we send folks down to the exhibit page here on the site? And
if you want more information on the Furuno NavNet TZtouch3 system, whether it be the user interface or the various models or all the different features and functionalities, including all the wide variety of sensors and third-party systems that can integrate with TZtouch3, go to the Furuno USA website to check it out and just search TZtouch3, and you'll find a host of information.
Eric, well, thanks. That's exciting. I can't wait to play around with it in person, get out of our quarantine and get back into our passions and our hobbies. I know, obviously, you're passionate about the product. I think it's something you guys should be really excited about. We appreciate you making time for us today.
No problem. Thank you, Eric. Talk to you soon.
And thank you guys for making time to join us here at the Virtual Boat Show. We encourage you to check out all the information and the links down below in the virtual exhibit page for Furuno. And stay tuned and check back in with us often. We're going to be bringing you some more great content from the virtual docks. In the meantime, I'm Eric Dallin with the AIM Marine Group. Thanks for joining.